Stability AI has been a key player in the generative AI game for quite some time. Compared to their closed source competitors like DALL-E and Midjourney, Stable Diffusion and Stability AI has been kept open source, which has been great for community. Not only is Stable Diffusion open source, but it has been the most professional tool compared to the competitors. Just consider all the features that we have in Stable Diffusion, like control nets, face swapping abilities, you know, stuff like that. Today marks a new era, and Stable Diffusion 3 is now available. AI. They say here on their Twitter, "Today we're pleased to announce the availability of Stable Diffusion 3 and Stable Diffusion 3 Turbo on the Stability AI Developer Platform API. We have partnered with Fireworks AI, the fastest and most reliable API platform in the market, to deliver these models." So what does this mean? I've had access to Stable Diffusion 3 for a few weeks now. I've been testing it out, seeing how it feels. I'll show you some quick examples in a bit. But basically, so far, Stable Diffusion 3 has been very limited and not been available to a lot of people. Now that has changed. So basically, anyone can use it through the API. In the example on Twitter here, they have a prompt that says, "Awesome artwork of a wizard on the top of a mountain. He's creating the big text, Stable Diffusion 3 API." This is the one that you see here, "with magic text at dawn, sunrise." So if you haven't seen my previous video on Stable Diffusion 3, what you can expect is better prompt understanding and the ability to prompt for text. As you can see in some of the examples that they put up on Twitter, which are, you know, obviously cherry-picked, but for a base model, they are very good. And this one, it says, "Prompt a red sofa on top of a white building, graffiti with the text, the best view in the city." So it says here, the best view in the city. It's spelled correct. We got a couple of extra dots down there, which I think is fine in the example here. The red sofa is actually on top of the white building. And, you know, they probably have the best view in the city. What of? Well, we don't know. We can see some of the background here, but that's about it. Another prompt here is, "Portrait photograph of an anthropomorphic tortoise seated on a New York City subway train." So, you know, this is what turtles would have looked like if it was kind of half semi-real. I wonder which one it is though. Leonardo? Donatello? Raphael? Oh, doesn't matter. It's one of them. Can't be anyone else. They keep on showing here just, you know, more. "Aesthetic, pastel, magical realism, a man with a retro TV for a head standing in the center of the desert, vintage photo." And what they're trying to show here is, you know, basically the prompt understanding. It's actually having a man with a TV for a head is surprisingly hard for the previous models. So you can put a lot of stuff in there, which I think is very cool. When I said in a lot of stuff, I mean, you know, a lot of text in the prompt, but also a lot of stuff in the images. So you can say, I mean, compared to when the new DALL-E was released, it was like, yeah, you can, you know, have this character there, this character there, you know, holding this and, you know, being in this background and this setting, whatever. And Stable Diffusion 3 is actually doing sort of the same thing. And this example is a cardboard box with a face. "They say it's not good to think in here," which is a quite long sentence. Shorter words though. "The cardboard box is large and sits on a theater stage." And I think, you know, it's pretty good. I got some key takeaways here. So Stable Diffusion 3 and Stable Diffusion 3 Turbo are now available on the Stability AI Developer Platform API. We talked about that a little bit. We have partnered with Fireworks AI, the fastest and most reliable API platform in the market. Yada yada, they said the same on Twitter. But there's some more information here which is not available on Twitter. And it goes on to say here, "As revealed in the Stable Diffusion 3 research paper, this model is equal to or outperforms state-of-the-art text-to-image generation systems such as DALL-E 3 and Midjourney V6 in typography and prompt adherence based on human preference evaluation." So human preference evaluations is, it's just basically, you know, you generate, let's say, 4 images, and then someone goes in and says, okay, this was the best one, and clicks, you know, kind of a voting system, right? And then, you know, they get 4 new images and say again, oh, this is the best one. So that's what they mean with human preference evaluations. They basically, you know, they're blind tested. Well, hopefully they're blind tested. If it's not blind tested, then, you know, that's bias. "New multimodal diffusion transformer uses separate set of weights for images and language representation." So that improves, you know, text understanding and spelling capabilities compared to previous versions of Stable Diffusion. And if you've been using Stable Diffusion for quite some time now, and if you've been with me through all of this journey from day one, you know that Stable Diffusion can't spell. I mean, it is what it is. We have found creative ways around that, especially with, you know, controlled. Here we got another set of examples of red sofas. So in this one, you have a red sofa in the middle of a beautiful garden, wooden sign with the text, "The best view in the garden," in pasto painting, colorful flowers. Hey, what do you call a fake noodle? An impasta. So we can see this one again, and then we have another one, "The best view at home." This one is an embroidery and colorful flowers, which I think looks pretty cool. So I did some testing of my own. I have this image, for example, which is just a big, quick test. I prompted for like a neon cyberpunk city street with AI Dad. So I got AI Dad here. I should probably get like AI Dad on the cap or something. I did check, you know, trying to test some of the skin capabilities, because a lot of the time with many molds, especially SDX7 when it was released, you get this overcooked, kind of overbaked result, you know, glossy, plasticky stuff. In this example, we got a pretty good skin, fairly realistic. It's a little too much, but it's a base model, so I would say that we're getting there. And it's looking pretty good. Segment on safety here. This says, "We believe in safe, responsible AI practices. This means we have taken and continue to take reasonable steps to prevent the misuse of Stable Diffusion 3 by bad actors. Safety starts when we begin training our model and continues throughout the testing, evaluation, and deployment. By continually collaborating with researchers, experts, and our community, we expect to innovate further with integrity as we continue to improve the model." So, I mean, it's a lot of words. It doesn't say specifically what they're doing, but I guess that's expected. You can't reveal all of the work, but just having a paragraph that says, you know, they're working on it. It being open source and uncensored, you know, I understand the concern. It's a hard topic. So again, to reiterate, guys, this you cannot download and use locally. It's only available through APIs. You need to use separate tools and platforms for it. But something interesting to say here, while the model is available via API today, as part of its initial launch, we are continuously working to improve the model in advance of its open release. You can anticipate seeing these improvements in the upcoming weeks. So we can expect to see an updated version before the weights are released. So, you know, that's kind of cool. But for now, it's going to be able through API, and they're working with Fireworks. So, yeah, what do you think? Is it going to be an improvement over 1.5 and SDXL? I think it kind of will, especially when we get some fine-tuned models that are trained by you guys in the community, because you are doing great work. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one. See ya.